The phenomenon of leadership and good governance has assumed greater interest in Africa. Since the return of democratic government in Nigeria, the need for good governance and national development have been of great concern to many Nigerians. Tunde Afe, a leadership expert and former gubernatorial candidate, spoke with PLUS TV Africa on the challenges of leadership and governance in the country.
I like to look at it this way. Do we really have a leadership style
in Nigeria? Good question to ask.
You know, because if you look at how our leaders have been selected over time, it has always been people focusing more on which section of the country is going to provide the next president. And until we depart from that, we are not likely to witness development in Nigeria.
And that's
for example, you know, the clamor for the next president now is on. Now people are saying the next president has to come from the southern part of the country without looking at, well, competence, looking at the ability of the leader to deliver, not looking at, okay, does this leader understand the problems we have in Nigeria?
Mm-hmm.
So until we depart from that, what if we now find somebody from the southern part of the country and he doesn't have, or he or she does not have the capacity and the ability to deliver?
Mm-hmm.
So we have to depart from that. We have to focus more on competence. We have to focus more on the leader's ability to deliver.
Before you go any further, because
yeah.
I'm going to ask you, yeah. you know, your suggestions on what solutions do you prefer. I know that you were once a gubernatorial candidate in Ekiti State.
Yes.
Now, what do you point out as the defects in selecting political leaders? You know, for instance, even your own experience during your time.
The defect is, you know, I just said that, you know, until we depart from focusing more on which part of the country we produce,
mm-hmm.
you know, the leader.
The quality of leaders.
Yeah, until we depart from that, we are not likely, mm-hmm. you know, to have good. And that has been a major defect until we address that. Nigeria is one. So we should focus more on the capacity, the ability, and then the character of the leader to deliver good governance. Once we focus on that, we will start to witness rapid development.
Now, Nigeria, some people have said Africa generally, and of course by extension, Nigeria has been plagued by some kind of leadership that is not working. Now, is the problem the leadership style or is the system that we adopt here as a people, as a country?
Yeah, it is both. You know, yeah, what is leadership? I normally like to define leadership as going the way and showing the way. Now,
going the way. Hold
going
on.
The way.
Let's even hear it. Going the
going
way.
Going the way and then showing the way. Now, you cannot take people to where you have never been. For example, if you have never been to, let's say, Ikeja, then how do you take a group of people from VI to Ikeja?
How do we direct them?
How do we direct them? How do we lead them? So leadership has to do with going the way and then leading the way. And then you now look at the system. It is the leadership that creates systems.
Mm-hmm.
Once we have good leadership, we're going to have good systems created. And once we have systems, you know, we can say, okay, if this person becomes the president or the governor, because of the systems, you know, the things that governance will be about is already stated. Because we have systems in place now, whoever becomes governor or president will deliver. The systems will force them to deliver.
We have also seen that there are some good leaders. We can't say, oh, everyone is bad. It's been all bad leadership. There are good leaders. But we've seen that good leaders, with good intentions, sometimes have not translated into good governance. Why is it so?
Yeah, it's very simple. It's one thing to have good intentions. It's another thing for you to be able to translate your intentions into reality.
Mm.
Now, people will not enjoy intentions. Intentions will not solve the problems of the welfare of people.
That's
intentions
correct.
Will not solve the problem of security. Now, you now need good systems in place to help you now translate your intentions into reality. So until we have good systems, we won't be able to translate intentions into, and until we have good leadership, we will not be able to create the right systems.
Okay, we're already in 2020. There's so much talked about 2020. What do you think our present leaders need to put in place now to enhance good governance moving forward?
Well, you know, leadership is all about having a vision. You understand? For example, I normally ask, what is our vision in Nigeria? Where are we going to? For me, I don't see a vision for Nigeria.
Even the vision 2020 talked about.
No. You see, the vision 2020 talked about is not really a vision. A vision will be, for example, we know what Israel is all about. We know what the United States of America is all about. What is Nigeria all about? To me, what Nigeria should be all about is stated in our constitution. And it says that the primary responsibility of governance or anybody that comes into governance should be the welfare and the security of the people. We can turn that into our vision. That would mean that now there is a serious security problem in Nigeria. And, you know, people are saying Nigeria is too large to secure. That's not right. Now, there are countries larger than Nigeria that are being secured through the use of technology. For example, Canada is about 11 times the size of Nigeria. And in Canada, they use drones, you know, drones to secure, you know, 1,000 feet apart. You can use drones to secure the places. So why don't we adopt that? You know, so that we can solve this problem of security in Nigeria once and for all. So if government focuses on that, I think that we will be able to give them a pass mark.